Hello and welcome. Today I want to talk a little bit about my bicycle equipment over here. So that's how it looks like. This is my sleeping system over here. Yes, okay, it looks a little bit heavy and a little bit big, but it includes everything to sleep outside without a tent. On the bottom of those two bags I have my clothes, all my stuff, then tent and also some cooking equipment. In the front bags I have always my food and some extra stuff. Then I have two Nalgene bottles, it's 2 liters together, and I like them very much because with this lid I can fill up in a stream or a river or something very easily. Over here I have a very comfortable air pump, I really like this one. So in my bedroll I have this sleeping mat for the ground. I have also an air mat and a pillow. So, and also I always take a silk liner for the sleeping bag with me. And then I have a ground sheet over here. This ground sheet can also be used as a tarp, so it's very practical. And then I have my army bivak sack. And this one protects my down sleeping bag from getting wet. So as you can see, this system is very simple and very easy to use also without a tent. So now I want to show you how my sleeping system looks like. And as you can see, it needs only a short moment to put everything up and you are ready to sleep. So the next thing that I want to show you is what I have in those two bags. These two bags are together, I think, around 8 to 10 kilograms. And it's very easy to open. So on top I have my camping pots, 2 of them. Then I have on the one side the stakes for the tent. Then I have here a shower bag, and also inside there is my tent. On the bicycle I also carry the one pole for the tent. So over here I have my warm clothing. I have socks, I have extra hat, extra down jacket, and a lot more gloves. So as you can see, first one is empty. And the next thing, my rain gear is very simple. I have gloves, I have a waterproof jacket, waterproof trouser. I also take very light jackets with me. Something like this from polyester, and also something from wool, like what I have on. Always I like to have a hood like this one has and this one, because you stay much more warm. And here I take my camera equipment and my electronic stuff. So that's all. Some more stuff that I had in the front bags are over here. Clothings, also gaffer tape, and also I really like to carry Crocs. Yeah, I know they are very very ugly, but extremely practical. In the evening I enjoy to have a small fire going on, and so I need something to cut wood, and I always carry this with me. I know it's extra weight, but it's definitely good to take with me. Something very important for me is my headlamp. My headlamp has different modes. I also can use it as a red light, so the battery lasts much more longer. To load this one up, I have AA Plus batteries. and I load everything with a goal zero system. I can load these batteries on my bicycle dynamo. So that's very practical, handy. Now I want to show you my clothings. Okay, we're going layer to layer. First, I take always extra pair of bicycle trousers with me. And not only this one, I take also merino wool underwear with me. It's very practical and very warm. I have 3 pairs of them. Then tons of socks, woolen socks and also synthetic socks, because much lighter and smaller and something that's much warmer. So a lot of socks. Then, very practical, I have 2 types of mask. This is merino wool mask and this is a synthetic mask. I can use this one as a hat, like this. Also, I can make something different out of it. So with this one I have much more protection. And with this one I have almost the same thing. If it's very cold, I take this one on for sleeping. Next layer is a merino wool underwear, long, and also a trouser. So, and over this one, I have a long and very thick woolen trouser. So it's very, very handy for cold nights. Also, if you want to cycle, you can also take this one on and it's much more warmer. Then I have a cashmere pullover one. I have my synthetic jacket with a hoodie. It's very practical. I have also a second jacket like this one with a hoodie. It's from merino wool. I have also this Norwegian pullover from wool. It's very, very good and also looks very nice. So, and under this jacket here, I have also a merino wool t-shirt. This is very warm and it's very, very good. It feels very soft and yeah, I like it a lot. But now it's cold, so I turn this on. All this gear here is for a little bit colder environment. If you go in springtime, winter or autumn, this one is the way you chose your stuff. In summer you can take some of this stuff away, but yeah, it's very good to have. I have also this down jacket with a hood. It's extremely light but very warm. I like it a lot. So then I have merino wool gloves, one layer. Synthetic gloves, one layer, and also waterproof ones on top. So 3 layers for my hands. Also, I like this small thing here. I can use this one for wind protection. I can also use this as a hat or whatever. So I like this also a lot. This one is also very practical. It's a mosquito hat. If you're somewhere in Scandinavia in the summertime, so you can use this one to protect you from the mosquitoes. So it's very handy. I like it a lot. I definitely would not go without it. And the cool thing is I can pack all my stuff that I don't need. So it's much more easier to find my gloves that I need or to pack everything away. So like this. Next thing is here inside of this, all my tools and extra stuff that I need. For repairing the bicycles, I have this one here and some more things depending on where I have to go, and gaffer tape, also a knife. Then I have my wooden spoon, some medical first aid kit stuff. Take this painkiller. I have a pencil
for writing something. So now I want to show you some of my electronic devices. I have this black diamond headlamp with a waterproof power bank. I can take the batteries out. As you can see, AA plus batteries, and then I can load them up with a Gold Zero loading station, the cables that I need for this one, and also cables for the GoPro. Also, I have in here my extra camera, so for some zoom effects. What I really highly recommend is this one from this brand, Anker, and I can load up 4 devices at the same time with a good speed. So it's a little bit heavy and big, but definitely good to take with me. I also take organic soda with me, so I can wash myself in the river or somewhere, take a shower or whatever. And also some lip butter for my hairs. I have something. Also, I have earplugs to listen to music and some extra plugs for the earplugs if it goes wrong. For take the lenses of my camera clean, I will take this one with me. And also, if you're somewhere in the city or you sleep somewhere on in the train station or whatever, this is very handy, the earplugs. I always take them with me because you never know where you have to sleep. I take some fishing rope with a hook with me. I take a needle with me for some small repairings. This one is very handy for my Thermarest air mat. I can repair it if there is a hole inside. If I have to sharpen my foldable knife, I can do this with a sharpener. So it's very practical. This one is a Switzerland knife called Wanger. I don't know if this is still available, but it's very, very nice because you have a very, very strong and big knife for a big hand like mine. You have also a saw and screws and smaller knives. I also carry some hooks extra with me, also some paracord. And always, I have something special here, and this is my very, very light and small tarp. I also can use the tarp as an extra rain gear, and it only weighs 140 grams. So it's extremely light, and if I fold this down, I can pack this one in my trouser bag. At the front bags, I have some more stuff for the kitchen, but this one is the main part. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this small video about my bicycle equipment. In the future, I will do some more videos about the gear that I take with me. And yeah, you will see some more stuff that I sometimes take with me. I hope you enjoyed it, and see you next time.